Baram Dam blockades here. Enters it 154 days today. We started on the 23rd October 2013 at a place called Data Kelawit. Usually, of course, we call it a blockade. We don't block any roads here, but then we made camp here. It is within the area of the proposed dam site, and we get the consent of the landowner here, so nobody can say that we put up camp illegally, because the owner of the land, the farmland here, he is with us. So we put up the blockade here. The blockade means we don't want our native customary land to be destroyed. I mean, more so if it is the dam, it is all flooded. So we gather here. It is not only from one longhouse. There are many longhouses here. Of course, not all of them are here now. So as I say, there are Kayans here, there are Penans here, there are Kenyah here also. So all of us, I mean, those who are against the dam, who doesn't like the dam, we are here to protect our land. See, our rights to the land is very, very important, because from the land, our life all come from the land. Our custom, our lives, because we farm the land. It has been there for generations. Our great forefathers, our great grandparents, they came to Baram. They fight for this land. That's why we own this land now. So we protect this land. We don't want this land to be destroyed. We don't want this land to be flooded. So that is what we are here for, to safeguard this land. So when the land is no more there, I think that's the end of it. Even if the government is giving us land, which we don't want, okay, there is no compensation. We don't go for any compensation. We want to stay put here. We don't want the dam, that's all. We don't go for any compensation. We don't negotiate for anything. Because this land is, it costs our lives. So money is nothing to us. So the land is most important. We protect this land. We own this land right up to the future generation. It's for them also, like what our great-grandparents did in the past. Previously, when we all started, because there was a lot of activities going on here, there is some surveying work, there is some logging activities, so there's quite a number of us here, even about 50 or 60 percent. So now that most of the activities has ceased, so no more logging, no more surveying, but of course you can see this SCB passing by here. So what we agreed, all the representatives from the various longhouses, what we agreed is that we can go back to our own longhouses, do our own work, whatever it is, because this is still harvesting season for some. But then there must be at least not less than 10% guarding this place, looking for, now at the moment there are only 10 of us here. So our purpose here is to memantau. Should there be any activity within this area, or maybe some logging activities going on, or even if the SEB will secretly send their surveyor back, so when we see this, we will start calling all the people from the various ones. They will come here. Is until the dam stop. That is what we meant it to be. until the dam stop. Even if even if it takes years, so we are ready to stay put here. The hardship is always there, and but we have some very generous friends who sometimes give us some food, but then we don't depend on this. We have our own ways from our own kampung. We contribute in terms of food, especially rice. In terms of food, there's no problem. So we can go to the small stream here to look for fish and go do some hunting to look for supplies. But then the main problem here is, of course, the transportation from the various longhouse to here, because it has to, that longhouse itself will have to bear the cost. Of course, blockade group here, of course, we don't have fun. See, this is not an NGO. This is a group of Baram folks who oppose the Baram Dam. Yes, we have to make collective decision, because there is no leader here. Because if you have a leader, it's only from one kampung, because there are many kampungs here. So now with the camp here, there are 14 kampungs here. We have to get everyone from this kampung to make a final decision, because even those who are here, they cannot make their own decision. If there is something very important, we will call everybody back here and then we discuss. Because no one is a leader, because there is no leader here. Everybody is leader. So we need help from outside, within Malaysia, from the town, and also from the outside world. That our main purpose here is to safeguard this sacred land. This land is our rights. So without this rights, there is no use to be called an orang ulu here now, or a kayan or a kenya. Because to be a kayan or a kenya without any land is the same. You know? So we want the outside world, we want our supporters, our friends from town, to help us to protect Baram land, which is native customary right land.